Lucid keeps bringing the heat, and with today's announcement, they may be the highest performing, longest range, fastest charging EV ever made. All right, let's talk specs. So the specs are really nutty, and they start out with 1,080 horsepower, which gives them a 9.9 second quarter mile time. 9.9 seconds, that's breaking that 10 second barrier, something that no EV has ever done. No EV that is, you know, made for an actual person to drive. Let's exclude the things like the Shelby Cobra Mustang electric thing they did, but a real EV. And this was the 5-seater version. So a normal EV that a regular person might own. And they're able to do it consistently, something that has always plagued a lot of performance electric vehicles, one that the Porsche Taycan held their hat on, and well, I think they were able to pull it off. It's kind of incredible seeing this in real life. And the CEO, CTO, Peter Rawlinson said in a statement that our watchword has been focus. Since day one at Lucid, a focus on sound engineering principles, a focus on creating efficiencies, and a focus on maximizing power to create a world-class EV. And Peter Rawlinson is a badass, in case you didn't know. He was the chief designer at Tesla, and the Tesla Model S was his baby. You know, the thing that kicked off this whole EV revolution. Yeah, he created that. Some other specs that are worth mentioning is that this car will have a 517-mile range, which was tested at a factory that is made to test these things. It wasn't like somebody just threw it in the wind and they came up with this number. This isn't some marketing hype. This was real testing that was done by them. So good, solid estimates there. We'll see what the actual EPA range is when it comes out. And this is on 113 kilowatt hours of energy. So a battery pack that is just 13 kilowatt hours greater than the 402-mile Tesla Model S long range, which is the current kind of EV champion in that space. This gives them a best-in-class 4.6 miles per kilowatt hour. That's better than the Model 3 with its efficiency and better than the Model S by a fair amount. It doesn't look like much when you're just looking at the numbers there, but if you look at the percentages, it's actually kind of a lot. A big reason why they're able to get this performance and these efficiencies is because of their 900 volt architecture. With everything kind of mashed together in a really compact unit here that they're talking about, will only weigh 163 pounds. They're able to fit three of these motors in a relatively small size. This means that in total, their motors and everything else will be 45% lighter and up to 59% more powerful than their closest competitor. I assume they're talking about Tesla here. Maybe you could throw in the Porsche Taycan, but I don't see that being a real competitor on efficiency. It is really performant and it's really incredible, but it burns through energy like crazy. So, you know, it's great, but it's not something that you would consider like this marvel of efficiency in the EV space, which is what they're claiming to have. Now, one quote that I found really interesting, but a bit technical, but I think it could be a big deal, is when they said that, most notably, an elegant and revolutionary new motor winding technology has been introduced to maximize power output and reduce electrical losses. The motor also features an innovative cooling system that more effectively removes heat from the stator winding, minimizing losses and boosting efficiency. Okay, so that means essentially that the way that they're handling heat inside of the motor is all new, and they're getting these bits as close to even inside of the motor to really kind of maximize efficiency. Because a lot of times what happens is the more energy that you push through a system, the hotter it gets, and heat kind of messes everything up. If you could keep it perfectly cool, you could really run these things as fast as you can imagine. So with this new technology, they're really able to kind of build this compact system that just works incredibly well, which fits right in line with what they're calling their space concept. In fact, the overall dimensions of the Air are smaller than the Model S is currently. So that's just an example of how much focus they're putting on this concept of efficiency. Now, something else they've already talked about, but I think is worth mentioning here, is what they're calling the V2X, or vehicle to anything charging. This means that with 113 kilowatt hours in your car, you could power your house, you could charge another car, you could feed that energy back to the grid, and maybe even get a credit from your utility for helping them kind of manage the peak load. So there's a lot that you can do if you can turn that battery sitting in your driveway into something more usable than just moving you to and from work. And that last bit there, where you can actually sell energy back to the grid and get paid for it, that's called a virtual power plant. Tesla's already doing this for a few states and a few partners with their Powerwall owners. So if you want to check that out, I'll put a link up here in the description so you can see more about how this is even possible. Now, speaking of that battery, Lucid's 900 volt architecture means less heat and more juice. So in this case, the Lucid Air will be able to charge up to 300 kilowatts at their partner, Electrify America. Now, these stations are popping up all over, but they're not as plentiful as the Tesla Supercharger network. But with 300 kilowatts, that means that on your end, you can get about 300 miles of range in just 20 minutes of charging. And to put that into perspective, 300 miles of range is gonna be between 4 and 5 hours of driving. For me, that's a good day. I guess if you're going cross country, you may want more than that, but I would assume that most people would find that plenty in terms of how much range they can actually get on a road trip, hopefully alleviating any kind of range anxiety. You know, plus also, when you think about charging during the week with 400 or 500 miles range, you don't really have to worry about it every day. It's not something you have to come in and plug in, like if you have 70 miles of range or 80 miles of range, which is what some of the original kind of cheaper, more economical EVs have. And for me and my family, that would be enough to where we could actually make it all the way to Phoenix. And if we did have to stop, we could stop just like we do now in Yuma. And instead of maybe 40 or 50 minutes, we would only stop for 20 or 30 or whatever. So it would cut down our charging time. But honestly, with over 500 miles range, I think, especially with two kids, we aren't going to be going over that. So you can just get to where your destination is and hopefully you're staying somewhere that has a charger and you'll be good to go in the morning. And let me just put a point on that. Yes, the Tesla Supercharger network is incredible and no one is even close, despite what graphics other companies may throw out there, what other kind of adjectives they may want to use to describe their charging network. No one is close to Tesla on this. But when you have 500 miles of range, I don't think it's as big of a deal, really. If you think about it, how often are you going to be driving more than 500 miles on a single day? You could rent a different car if you want. You could rent a Tesla. You could rent a gas car. I mean, a lot of families still have a gas car for these reasons. So I think it's something that, yes, if you're a hardcore Tesla fan and you just want something to hang your hat on, go for it. You can say that the Tesla Supercharger network is better in every way, and you're not wrong. But when you think about practicality, 500 miles of range is plenty. And you're rarely ever going to need more than that on a given day. So can we just set that argument aside and just be impressed at what these guys have been able to do? And so with all the stuff that Lucid has already announced, I'm really looking forward to some healthy competition between Tesla and Lucid. I mean, these specs and these things are just undeniably great. And they're coming from Peter Rawlinson, a guy that designed the Model S, not designed like the shape of it, but the engineering bits that made it so special. So there's no reason to doubt any of this. And if you're like me, you should be a fan of new EVs coming out that are really compelling, that are gonna drive this forward. And in fact, Lucid invited me back to their store in Beverly Hills to have a preview of this prior to it coming out. So the biggest thing that I noticed when I saw it in person was just sorry about that. So that's it for this one. Stay tuned for more. As I mentioned, I will have a sneak peek for you the moment that the unveiling comes out. So subscribe down below, turn notifications on, get on my email list apparently, because it's not enough just to do those things. You can go over to bensolins.com/join. It's free. I won't spam you. I just send you videos. It's pretty easy, but it's a way to work around this YouTube nonsense as they try to figure out their algorithm. So that's it for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget, when you free the data, your mind will follow. I'll see you back here in the next one.